jump so high.
Hi, it's me, Lukan the Legend, here from Deja Vu FM, and I'm here with Lion Babe.
What's up?
Howdy, howdy, howdy. Right, so the obvious question is Lion Babe.
Yes.
Please explain the name to me, because I've got a thing about names.
You know, it's, we were just saying before, it's definitely a multi-meaning name, and I think actually we first kind of came up with it, and we just like said it, and we're like, oh, that's kind of weird, but it's cool, it sticks, and I think over time we've, you know, we found out what it really means to us, and, you know, Jillian is a lion. I'm a Leo, and
what makes Jillian a lion?
She just is a fierce woman, you know. So
she's scary.
Yeah,
she's, you know. But also
not scary,
just fierce, you know. It's different, like when she has to be. But also, you know, it's just a dual thing, like the two kind of sides of it. The lion is strong, mm-hmm. The babe is, you know, beautiful and sultry, and you know, it's just the Jill's a Gemini, so you know, all sorts of duality we're really into, and
I want to just get across the fact that it's a duo, Lion Babe. Because I assume that a lot of people might think that Jillian is Lion Babe.
Totally.
Does that happen a lot? Do people like... Because when I was looking at it, I was thinking, you know, it's sort of like the Jamiroquai thing where people might think that the guy is Jamiroquai and then the rest of the guys like maybe roadies or something. Like, who knows? So do you get that people assume that you Jillian are Lion Babe, and then people might say, oh, hello. Does that ever happen?
That's happening a little bit.
Yeah, you know? A little bit. Yeah. But I mean, I think it's all, like Blondie is a huge example for us. Like, people thought Debbie Harry is Blondie.
Yeah. Blondie's like the band.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's all good. It's like, you know, people who don't know, they don't know.
But that must be annoying.
And I'm like, he's open to dance around in a leotard whenever he wants to. I just know he doesn't want to.
I know she can do it a little better than me, though.
Yeah.
You know what? I wouldn't want to see it. I've got to be honest. Keep it as it is. So you both got different roles in the group. I understand that you, Lukas, you play a lot of instruments.
Yeah, I produced the music and like just did this stuff, you know.
What instruments can you play?
I grew up playing guitar, you know, bass, and you know, naturally through that, you know, you're at music school, you figure yourself away around the keyboards and piano and stuff like that. And I really
how do you naturally go from strings to keys?
I don't know. Well, piano is like a good like elementary instrument, because one thing that's nice is like all the notes are still the same note as you go up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Based on what, so yeah, you just, you know, you just figure it out. It's just music's fun, so you just play until. No.
I'm teaching myself piano. I'm stuck. Literally stuck. I've got like five fingers, well, obviously, like little people. Each hand. And as soon as I've got to move outwards, it's a wrap for me. I'm over. I don't know how you learn it on your own. You taught yourself.
Well, you know, I went to school like, and there's like music theory class and stuff like that. But it's like kind of like, you know, you can kind of like figure out what the chords are. And like that's the thing.
I can't.
If the chord's like one chord down here, is the same chord up here. So it's like, you know.
Okay. Yeah. So Jillian, you're effectively like the front face of the band then.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you another reason why people might think that you are Lion Babe rather than anyone else. So when I knew I was coming here, I decided to add you lot on Instagram.
Yeah.
And then it's all you all over Instagram. Are you in charge of Instagram?
I am.
Oh, you are? It's your Instagram? Yeah. That would explain that.
Yeah.
Okay. So
my Instagram used to be Lion Babe X, because I didn't want to be just Lion Babe, but they decided that was, you know, easier to get people there.
Yeah.
So I tag him in everything he's in.
Yeah.
I take more pictures than he does.
Yeah, that is very notable.
Like, yes.
Seriously. So you're effectively the front of the band. You do the singing and the vocals and that sort of thing. How did you get involved in music initially as well?
It kind of hit me a little randomly. I grew up dancing predominantly. That was my thing. And, you know, I've always been very musical. My family's musical.
Yeah.
I took chorus my whole life and, you know, it wasn't an a cappella group in high school. But never really, I always knew that if I wanted to sing, I was going to want to like write my own music or sing in my own way. I didn't really want to do voice lessons or anything like that.
Yeah.
And then, you know, really hearing his sound was kind of the first time I ever started thinking about melodies or songwriting in general. And that just kind of organically just was like, oh, he seems chill enough to let me try. And it kind of...
How did you two meet?
We met through a mutual friend of, like, my family friend, my mom's best friend's son. Went to college with him.
And he's like one of the first friends I made when I got there. You know?
Right, okay.
And then so we linked like 4 or 5 years ago, briefly at a party, and then, you know, in New York, it's kind of like similar circles of friends. Mm-hmm. You know everyone, so we kind of just got reconnected.
Yeah.
I was dancing at the time and needed someone to score like a dance piece for me. Mm-hmm. He was the only producer I knew, so I asked him. And then, you know, from there, I think I was just kind of coming into my own as a dancer, but I was also looking to, you know, I was trying to act, I was trying to do all these different things, and then singing kind of just happened next. So
4 years ago.
Yeah.
So you were put like as one of the ones to watch for 2015.
Right.
So in 4 years, that's quite quick, really, isn't it? Really, quite a quick turnaround. Or do you not?
Well,
think so?
I mean, even Lion Babe didn't really start till 2012.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, really, that first song, Dream Like Fire, when we put that up, it was like we like start working on it like, a couple months before, like, oh, let's finish this. It's fun. We're going to start making music together.
Yeah.
And we were just like, well, let's finish this and make a video so like we can actually put it on the internet. So like when we meet people or want to get a show, you can send it to them. Like you can actually Google it. So it's like you're not on the internet. You don't really exist.
Absolutely. Yeah.
You know, so. And then that was just it. And then we actually were like, oh yeah, now we can get a gig. But we're so fortunate that, you know, blogs, especially out here in the UK and Europe, they were like picking up on it. And they're like, oh, yo, you know, there's been, I think even some people might have thought we have more music done when we put that one song out.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh no, it's the only song. We gotta like go make more music. We'll be back.
Do you find you have more of a following over here than over there?
Oh, no. You know, it's catching up.
Yeah.
In New York, you know, people definitely know.
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. But it's catching up. I mean, out here, guys definitely like, you know, picked up on us though first, like a little heavier. Yeah.
So over here, like when we have artists over here, they always say, okay, well, I'm doing all this work in the UK, but they make a special effort a lot of the time to try and break the US.
Mm-hmm.
Does that happen in reverse ever? Do you like go out of your way and say, okay, well, I'm actually, we've got a good fan base here, let's go to the UK and see what we can do over there? Is that a deliberate attempt or is it just something that naturally happens?
I mean, naturally happened
because people over here are like, you want to come over here and make music? And we're like, no one was really saying it over there yet. So we're like,
we kind of just followed like who was responding. And so, you know, we actually signed in the UK first.
Yeah.
Just because for us it made sense because we're like, okay, they're into it here.
Yeah.
And, you know, we can build a following hopefully faster. And then we're from New York. So obviously we're hoping America will just happen because we're from there.
Yeah.
And it's starting to. So.
Yeah.
So what's brought you over to London now? I know you had a few, because a friend of mine, but someone that I know, and I was actually with on Saturday, Coco Dupree.
Oh, yeah.
She posted a picture of that. She was with me. So,
you won with her last night.
That's right, So you've been gigging.
Yeah, kind of just like smaller, intimate things. We did our first like official gig here at Studio Spaces in East London earlier this month, which was really great. But yeah, we're just like here doing some press and kind of just doing some recording. It's actually really fun recording here because you can kind of escape your life and just focus. And
do you find it better to get away from your normal environment?
Yes and no.
Yeah, it varies.
Yeah.
But I think it's a nice change, definitely.
Yeah.
And the mood of like, just like, you know, when you're in a different place, you kind of think differently. So you might write something that you won't write in New York.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Totally.
I overheard something about the Brits. Are you performing at the Brits?
We're doing a little DJ tonight.
He's DJing.
Well, but she'll be there. She'll be toasting and stuff.
Oh, is that like an after party thing?
Yeah. We're not actually playing a gig.
Okay. So the EP was released towards the end of last year.
Mm-hmm.
Lion Babe. What did you set out? What was your ultimate goal when you first released it?
Our main goal was to give everyone just
new
like
music.
New music definitely, and really just you know, a further introduction to us and like our world and our music and our sound, and really just make it, you know, the first stepping stone for us, like in the history of this Lion Babe thing. You know?
And how's that gone so far?
Good. We're so happy with it.
Yeah.
I've heard your music, let's say about towards the end of last year.
Mm-hmm.
And I, as you said earlier, I thought that you must have had loads more music to, in your catalogue, and it's your first release, the Lion Babe EP.
Mm-hmm.
What's next for you then? Because that's a 4-track EP. How do you make an EP before going to that? Sorry, because I always think like making an album must be nuts because you make all this music and most people might have like 50 tracks and they whittle it down to like 10, say. How do you whittle it down for an EP? That must be like a challenge.
I feel like even when we're working on that, we like knew what the EP was going to be from the beginning.
Yeah.
Because it was basically we made Dream Like Fire and then we made 3 songs after that.
So you just made the 4 tracks?
Well, we started on them, but then we were also working on the album all the time. We weren't even really making it like that. We were just like, let's just make a bunch of music for like a year and a half.
Yeah.
But the first 4 that we started in that year and a half were like, Those are the ones that I feel right to go first. And we're like, you know, these will come later because we've learned all this new stuff afterwards.
Yeah.
So like that'll be the next bit, you know.
So you're working, so obviously you got other music out, so you're going to put that towards an album.
Yeah.
When's that going to be released?
September.
Yeah, we're aiming this year.
It's close to done.
Yeah?
Yeah, we were like, you know, we didn't want to leave you guys again for so long, so we made sure when the EP was there that we didn't just have that, we already had a bunch of other music in the stash.
And you had like Childish Gambino on the EP.
Yeah.
Who's going to be appearing on the album?
Feature-wise? We don't actually know.
Not yet. Yeah. There's like other producers we're working with, which is really awesome, but as far as like other artists or vocalists, nothing yet.
Got no preferred people that you want to work with?
Trying to get Q-Tip
on it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was very certain that you're definitely trying to get. Why Q-Tip?
We had the honor of just meeting him and kind of just vibing with him, and we were playing him some music, and there was one track that he was super into, so, you know, I'm just texting him every now and then, like, hey, and he's like, hey. I'm like, okay, when are we doing this? So I think it's going to happen, which will be awesome, but, you know.
But he's also just, like, you know, definitely one of the main influences and forefather teacher vibes for us, music, sound, and all that.
What about over here in the UK? We've got our own little thing. We have a bit of hip hop, but we've got our own thing called grime. I don't know if you've been introduced to that just yet. We've got other artists as well that do like R&B and whatever it might be.
Mm-hmm.
Any artists that you might be interested in working in the UK? Working with, should I say, in the UK?
James Blake.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely. Who else?
Jillian doesn't look so sure.
She's definitely about that. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. No, I love James Blake. I'm just trying to think of some other people.
Yeah, some other folks.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I know he just won, like, every Grammy ever, but, like, to challenge myself or to do something cool, I'm like, I would love to see what would happen if I did something with Sam Smith.
Yeah. Disclosure.
Yeah, Disclosure's cool. Dope. Yeah, there's a bunch. Every time I get asked this question, I blank out so bad. I'm going to just, you guys all have to follow me, so I'll tweet everything. I'll be like, I want to work with all of you.
It's doable. You're over here now. Make use of the time, right?
Yeah, well, hopefully tonight at this party, we'll meet some people.
Yeah, definitely.
Because you never know. It's always nice in person. It's just like connections easier.
Breaking into the industry, because it's hard. There's so much music out there and so many people are doing it because it's so easy now compared to, like, say, 20 years ago. What were the main challenges you had or obstacles that you faced?
I mean, like, I agree with what you said. Like, now it's kind of like a nice one advantage we have today is, like, when you got a laptop, it's pretty much like you can make the record on it and you can put it, distribute it ultimately through YouTube or whatever on it. So
all
you
from
can
a kitchen table.
Yeah, all from that. So, right. So that's a great advantage we have. I think a difficulty was, like, you know, when people started emailing us and hitting us up, like, it was a little overwhelming and we didn't really, know anyone in the industry, but we know everyone knows each other.
Yes, right, yeah.
So, like, it's a small world. So that was, like, the biggest learning experience. And I guess just certain things that I guess are super normal to industry folks, like, as far as, like, promotion or, I don't know, blah, 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 you know what I mean? That for us, we're like, oh, we're just, like, trying to make some music and stuff that we're, like, learning about more now. But,
Or just understanding that it is a business, like, whether or not you want it to be, because most artists probably don't, and they want to fight it all the time. And, you know, I'm not saying that I'm not one of those artists. I might, you know, I do like to just focus on the creative, but, you know, just understanding, like, how to see everything you want to see and what are you really valuing? What are you willing to bend on? What are you not going to bend on? You know, that kind of just, like, dealing with it as, like, you know, you have to protect your brand and your business kind of mind, even though you're trying to be creative. It's like, you have to know how to balance that.
Yeah, and, you know, just use it all to be like, it's good to know, like, what do you want, you know? And
what do you want out of
it? So then you can know what you're trying to do and how you can get there. So I think for us, that's something that we definitely started thinking about and learning because, like, you know, like we said before, it was just like, we just put this up so that, like, we could share it. And now it's like, now we have this opportunity, like, what are we going to do with it, you know? So, yeah.
How many times do you ask you two are a couple?
About a handful of times.
Does that come up quite often? I would have thought that's another annoying question that you get as well.
I mean, it makes sense, I guess. I don't know.
Because I was speaking to someone else the other day about it, and they were asking me, and I was like, oh, I bet that, like, management will say that you're not allowed to become a couple and blah, 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 blah. Like, are there any rules that are put, like, together in place that you can't do certain things?
Yeah, we wouldn't
listen
to those
rules. I mean, I
make
my own rules.
Yeah. Screw the
rules. So does he.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't listen to that.
I don't know. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's just like you gotta do what you gotta do and share whatever you want to share.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you know, for us, we just want to focus on the music. That's really.
Yeah.
I think when we ever get like opportunities to do things that, oh, this could be cool, but it's not actually about the music.
Yeah.
Right now, it doesn't seem appropriate. You know what I mean? So we'll see what happens like down the line. But.
So the music's coming out. So you got another album coming out in September. You said.
Yeah. September.
Have you got any music that you've got lined up ready to drop before the album comes out, like visuals and stuff like that?
Yeah, mm-hmm. We got like some singles that are gonna lead up to it.
Not from the EP, but from the album.
From the album,
brand new stuff, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you haven't got any collabs just in places yet?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we have producer collaborations.
Yeah.
Oh, so who else is producing?
We did a song with Pharrell.
Okay.
And we did a song with Jeff Basker. Wyatt, Dave Sitek. I mean, we've had like, you know, pretty awesome opportunity. Like one of our first things. I don't know what's gonna happen with this record, but I mean, you know, we were in the studio with Mark Ronson.
Yeah.
A super cool dude. But yeah, and you know, there's. I mean, we just started a new song last time we were out here, so that's gonna be on there. That we started two songs with. You know, this dude Joel Compass.
Yeah.
So he's a good friend of ours, and we've done some stuff with him. So always new stuff. I mean, who knows? By the time this album comes out, there might be a whole other album ready to go.
Did you find that you're always producing, like, constantly?
You know, I like to make beats kind of all the time. It's just, like, fun to do. Like, sometimes there's, like, the records that I know we got to work on and finish.
Yeah.
But that's, like, the work. Like, the fun stuff is, like, when you make something right then and there, you're not thinking. There's, like, no checklist of, oh, I got to add this part or fix this bit. It's just, like, you just make something fresh. That's always fun.
Lion Babe, it's been a pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. For anyone listening, look out for Lion Babe. You can catch the video on Vivo. Got you on Vivo channel, haven't you?
We're on Vivo now. Vivo.
Ooh. yeah.